Hey everybody, oops. Hey everybody, good afternoon. I just wanted to make sure that was turned up. How's everybody doing today? Oh, my hair is going wonky. It's very hot here today. Gussie's gonna need a haircut again pretty soon. Welcome to the stream, you guys. Welcome to the program. I'm Gussie Moose, your queen of all the creatures of Middle Earth. It's getting hot already. It's getting hot today. I will hang on in the stream as long as possible. I'm going to shoot for 90 minutes. We will definitely see how that goes. Yeah, just bear with me. I woke up at 8 o'clock this morning, watered my friends, our friends, down the road, their front yard, their backyard, came back up here, watered our front yard, backyard, had to get Bill's breakfast and lunch and stuff ready. So it's already been a long day for me, and it seems like just like 30 minutes ago, you could just start feeling the heat radiating all of upstairs here. So I do have my window open in the back. Hopefully it'll stay quiet outside. Indy's behind me sleeping. We will just see how it goes today. Good to see you guys. Good to see everybody here. Tansy, hi, how are you doing? Caduthi, good to see you, sir. Who we got in the house? Who do we got here today? I don't want to call you out in case you're, you know, lurking or being quiet for reasons or stuff, but if you say hi, I will holler back and give you a shout out. Gonna just kind of keep it cool and casual again today. Hey Wolf, how are you doing? Raise the cam. Oh, okay, I see how that's gonna be. Sorry, we're not gonna put up with that kind of stuff. This is a family-friendly channel, and that kind of stuff's just not tolerated. So, if you want to go see that stuff, I suggest you go see Legendary Leia. Just saying. Anyway, hope it cools off. Actually, we're supposed to hit... Today's supposed to be the coolest of the 4 days. Maybe 87, 88. The rest of the weekend is supposed to be high 90s here where I live. And probably triple digits on the other side of Washington. So, let's see here. While everybody is getting in here into the room, I just want to go over a couple things with you all really quick. The new Lotro store sales are up, and if it hasn't started already, actually it did start because there's our little heart right there. Welcome back, weekend has begun. You guys, 25% experience on monster kills, your crafting, your quest completions, legendaries, and your mounted combat is all going to be 25% more XP this weekend. That's pretty killer. For a hot weekend, that'd be something really good to do, would be to level up some characters. 50% off expansions, quests, and more. We were just talking about this yesterday in my stream. It was a kind of a quiet stream yesterday. We were talking about in the chat how after we finish our Lone Lands, Slayer Deeds sessions in the next couple weeks, my question was like, okay, where do we go from here? You know, there isn't really too much more of the free-to-play content, quote-unquote. Hopefully people are, you know, raising enough turbine points or whatever to get ready for the next area. And it's probably going to be, what is it we were thinking about yesterday? Let's see. North Downs. Thinking about doing the Slayer Deeds in North Downs and then possibly working our way into Vendheim after that. Which means if you're going to do Slayer Deeds with me for the next series that comes up, you're going to want to make sure you have the content for this. So, guess what? 50% off on expansion and expansion quests, skirmishes and instances, Your enhanced XP supplies are going to be 30%. I'm sorry. Skirmishes, enhanced XP supply, the token of Hornburg, and your mark acquisition books are all going to be 30% off. But your expansion and your expansion quests are 50% off this week. That's awesome. So those of you that are trying to save up your turbines to get ready for, like I said, I think we'll do North Downs next. This is perfect. This worked out just perfectly. You can get your quest packs half price. I think they're usually like what, almost, they're 595 or something like that. So if somebody can do some number crunching for me, let me know what the costs would be for, say, Lone Lands. Out of curiosity, what would it cost somebody turbines to do Lone Lands? That would be awesome. I'd love to find that out. Your freebie code, I'm going to post it up here for you guys. There you go. We get a loot key, so hopefully we'll get some good boxes dropping this weekend during the XP, the 25% XP boost this weekend. So you guys make sure and grab that sturdy steel key, because you know those things run about 15 to 20 gold sometimes in the auction houses if you don't have one. So definitely grab this and keep it, put it in your bank until you get a box to drop, and then that way you won't even have to worry about it. Anyway, there you go. The coupon code is loot key. So anyway, that being said, I can't think of too much more that I need to like really go over. I got on one of my alts today. Actually, let me pull up the LOTRO page here for you guys. My screen there. Here we go. I'm actually on Ken Ho Ken Hollis. I'm on an alt that I have, Callie. Haven't been on her too much in a while, other than just doing like festival stuff, things like that. And apparently, I still have some things in my bank, in my bag that I don't need. That's how much I. Excuse me, that's how much I actually really play on her. But the reason I got on her is because she's a hunter. Now, those of you that know me know that I usually play a blue line hunter. Nimwen is blue line. I've leveled her up that way from the get-go. But I was thinking, you know, everybody's saying, hey, try out different specs, you know, which totally understandable. So I am. I'm kind of thinking I don't really need that right now. Let's put the boost back on there. Get as much out of this weekend as I can anyway. I'm really thinking of maybe changing her spec. Where's her guides to Bree? Let's put her in Bree really quick. She's 37. I could probably go ahead and take her to a vending, to be honest with you, once I get her situated. I'm thinking about taking her to a vending, but what I want to do is I want to try. I hope I'm gonna like this, but I want to try Redline. I want to change her talents. I want to put her in Redline, and I just want to see if I'm gonna like it as much as I like my blue line or not. So, yeah. Okay, why did I come to Brie? What was the reason? My bags? Was that it? Apparently, I have some dye in my bags too. I don't think I really need to worry about emptying my bags right now, and if I do, I can always do that in a little bit. I'd rather just kind of get going here. Okay, so quest log. Where was the last place I went? North Downs, which was the last place I was actually apparently questing at. Lone Lands, you can see I never. Did I finish all of these? Is that what all those check marks? You guys, I'm gonna go turn these in really quick. We're gonna take a quick detour to Lone Lands, and then I am going to hop my way over, and I'm gonna try and head over towards a vending. Yeah, I wanna try. I'm gonna try red line. Let's go ahead and just, let's see. Is this how I do it? Go to number, wait, go to, no. This is my second spec. Yes. Okay, so we're gonna try red lines just for today and see how I like it. Okay. So we definitely want to increase my crit chance. That's the first thing. And decrease the target's mitigation against penetrating shots. Let's see, one. How come these are all dropped down? Okay, hang on a second here. What am I doing wrong? Oh, I guess I already had been working on it. Okay. I think I'd made the points, but I just hadn't worked on it, per se. Rain of Arrows. I don't really think I want to do that right now, because I don't want to hit multiple targets right now. I want to play it safe. So, let's see. Hey, Princess Quill, how are you doing? Sorry if it's a stupid question. Can you explain the difference between blue and red line? Thank you, Lupus. Well, blue line is this. When you're in a blue line trait on your hunter, because each class is different, on your hunter, your blue line, you do a little bit less DPS, but you have mobility. You can cast your shots while you're moving. In red line hunter, you don't have that mobility. You stand and shoot. And yellow line, which is another one that I haven't even begun to think about yet, yellow line specializes in using traps while you're in your spec. Which I don't know if that's kind of my cup of tea or not. So red line does give you more DPS, but you don't get the mobility. You can't, what's the word I want to use? Oh my God, what's the word I want to use? Like, I can attack something and I can strafe, I can walk backwards, I can pull the ad along with me while I'm continuing to DPS it down in blue line. Whereas red line, I just have to kind of sit there, shoot, move, reposition, shoot, that type of thing. You don't get the mobility that you do with a blue line. For Hunter, that's the difference between red and blue. Hey, Lotro Tavern, how are you, hun? Beebs, good to see you. Good to see you. Step back, yeah. What are we used to? Kiting. That's the other term I was thinking of, kiting. Which was something I really enjoyed doing in most games that I play as a hunter type of a class. I really enjoy mobility and kiting and stuff like that. But I'm going to try it for today. We'll try it red line and just see how it goes. I'm not sure, but we'll see. Try putting a point in Heart Seeker. I think I'm just going to redo this because I feel like this line is weird. Okay. One, two, three. Because crit's important. Four, five. Fast draw. Quick shot grants a stacking buff that which reduces the inductions. You want, since you're red line, you want to be able to get your shots off as fast as possible. So definitely gonna want to do that. I should go ahead and put my Heart Seeker up. Heart Seeker is like, if you use your Heart Seeker on a NPC, they can't dodge it, they can't parry it, they just have to kind of sit there and take it. So for a red line, you definitely want to have Heart Seeker because of the damage that it will deal. Let's see. Increase Swift Bow's damage per rank. Swift Bow, I use that quite a bit. So one probably should, I don't know if I need to worry about The target's mitigation. Oh, against penetrating shots. See, and that's my pin shot right there. Should probably put a point in there for now. I know I'm just low level anyway, so. Quick escape. That's a low cut. It kind of roots. It's kind of like a little trap type of thing. Lets you move back without dropping all your focus. The more focus you have, is what helps you with your shots. So, let's see. Deadly precision. Let's see. What's this one? Strength. Increase the range damage. Because you're going to be. Whereas in blue line, I tend to be in intent concentration. In this one, I'm going to be in. I'm sorry. I'm in precision stance a lot in blue line. Because I want my focus to regenerate really fast in blue line because I'm moving so much. But I think in this one, I'm going to try strength stance. So let's bump that one. Let's give that a little bit more. Let's give this one some more. Press onward. Heals a great deal of morale and power. I definitely want that. Anything I can do to heal myself. Wondering if I should go with a second point. Hey Rodney, how are you doing? Good to see you. Heartseeker is the big hit. Exactly. Yeah, that's what I was thinking is like use the Heartseeker as an opening and then going through my rotation after that. Of course, I've got my Bard's Arrow. You all know how much I love Bard's Arrow. Low cut, we'll put down here. This is Pinning Shot. It's a kind of a quick route. If you need to use it, this is my Cry of Hunter. That's my oh shit button, basically. I got my Merciful Shot. I'm gonna have my Penetrating Shot. My Swift. My Barbed. Actually, these two should be moved around. There's that. And let's see. Increase the power and morale gain of Press Onward. Let's go ahead and bump that one. And let's go ahead and do Deadly Precision. Oh, I can't. Can I? Yeah, here we go. Okay, so I've gotten a Needful Haste increase. Shoot to kill increases your ranged damage. And the next one is Archer's Mark. Gonna have a chance to apply stacking critical defense buff. So, almost there. Okay, commit to changes, yes. Okay, this gave me my Press Onward. We'll put that right there. I'm not gonna really need Endurance Stance, so let's get that off of there for now. Because I just confuse myself otherwise. This is my thing. This is that. Return to Stelding. I don't need two of those. Heartseeker, we'll put right here. Yeah, we'll keep it there for now. We'll see. I might move Heartseeker again. There's my foes and my nature. I don't really use my melee too much. Here's DPA, or here's my trap. Okay, this is a guide, this is a guide, that's a guide, that's a guide. We're gonna go for that. Let's try that and see how that goes, you guys. Okay, so. So, like I said, let's go ahead and head out really quick. Bear with me because I just moved everything around. Oh, hey, by the way, you guys, pass the word around and stuff. Let everybody know. I'm going to be doing a turbine point code giveaway. Cordovan hooked up with a couple of codes for some turbine points. And since I'm on the official channel today, I feel it's the best time to do it. My Moobot, or our Moobot, is up and running thanks to Eldolith for setting all that up. So I believe it's already turned on. You just need to make sure you're a follower of this channel first. Once you're a follower, you can go ahead and type in exclamation point raffle throughout the stream. You only need to do it once. You don't need to spam it, please. Go ahead and type in exclamation point raffle. You need to be present at the time of the drawing. when I call the winner's name so that I can Twitch message you your point code. And it's actually kind of a nice thing, some extra turbine points for a lucky person with all these sales going on this weekend. Someone's gonna have a lot of extra fun this weekend, that's for sure. So pass the word around, tell your kinnies, retweet. I'm thinking that the tweets went out. I actually didn't get a chance to check tweets. Let's see here. It's been a couple of weeks since I've been back on this channel because I was on vacation for 2 weeks prior. So let's see, share. Let's try this. I'm going to send out a tweet. If you guys are a follower on Twitter, on the LoTro Twitter, do me a favor, go ahead and retweet that out. Let people know that we're live. Okay, I could probably. Is there a
What
quick.
can I do for you?
Let's see here. Lone Lands. Oh, I thought there was a quick travel to Lone Lands. That's okay. We'll go ahead and do this. That way, it'll give me a chance to chit chat with everybody. What I'm going to do is I'm going to turn in some quests that apparently this character had. Go turn them in really quick, and then after that, we're going to start making our way out. I really want to try head out towards maybe a Vendeem. With her level, she should be okay. She's 37. And that way it'll give me a chance to just kind of work on the spec at the spec for right now. See how we like it. Oh, wonderful. Okay, they are the tweets are posting. Wonderful. So that being said, while we're waiting for her to get to Lone Lands, what do you guys have planned for this weekend? You guys gonna take advantage of the XP boost? Are you guys going to purchase some quest packs that maybe you've been holding off on or hadn't had a chance to do? What do you guys have planned for the weekend? It's going to be kind of hot. I know we're all going through a heck of a time between a heat wave and down south where they're having horrible conditions from the flooding and just everything. It's going to be a crazy weekend. So hopefully you guys will have some fun, kind of rest and relax this weekend and kind of just sit back, hang out with family and friends and get some game time in, work on some, maybe get on an alt that you haven't really played too much on, like I am, and take advantage of the buffs and stuff this weekend. It's very pretty. So pretty. I don't think this character even has much in terms of mounts or anything like that. I've just really not worked on her very much. She was a character. This is on Gladden, by the way. She was a character that was on one of the servers that got shut down. I don't even remember which one it was anymore. But this character was one of those. Oh, I need to move my character overs. And then I got lucky. I went into the Rangers of the West Guild and and there she has sat for a while. So let's see. Put a host up on my page just in case there's anybody hanging out on my Gussie Moose one page. I should at least pop the host up on there in case there's somebody chilling out over there. Okay, that's up. And is my dashboard up? Yep, dashboard's up today. Don't forget, you guys, if you are new to the LoTro Stream channel, please feel free if you're enjoying the stream to hit the follow button. Our community leader, Cordovan, has been amazing this past month and a half, with really kind of putting the pieces back together and getting things going and moving forward and stuff, and it's just been really wonderful. We've got lots of new streamers that are coming on board, and are on board already. Alapena just did his first official stream last night. Maiden of Rohan did hers this past week. SKD did his this week. That's three new streamers on their first officials this in a past week. I don't know if those of you remember or have seen. Why do I not have turn-ins? All these quests say turn-in. Is that not what the check mark's for? Oh, I wonder if I'm in the wrong place. I went to the wrong place, didn't I, you guys? Wait, let's see. I talked to Elmo CR, our streamer from Germany. That he's been taking a break for a few weeks. They've been working on stuff. They've got a lot going on right now. Their kin's been extremely busy during the summer. Talked to him, and a couple of the kinnies came into the stream yesterday. And are looking at hopefully coming back and streaming again soon. Their their streams are really fun to watch. Tiarda makes the neatest videos for intermissions. Anyway, so I talked to Elmo CR, and I'm hoping that maybe he'll get back in here in a few weeks or so, and we can get him set up as well. There's just been a lot of really good stuff going around, lot of going on a lot lately, lots of community interaction. We had a visit from Quartermaster Yu this week during the week. It's just been a really great time, and I know they've been really busy. They got a lot of stuff getting ready to happen in the game in the future as well. So I'll turn this on so I can. There we go. Weather's not looking so good in the UK. What's going on out there? Is that Dicity? Welcome. Yes, that's right. There is 50% off on expansions and quest packs, which is perfect. Like I was just mentioning in the beginning of the stream. For those that were getting ready or preparing to join me for the next series of Slayer Deeds, once we get done 2 more weeks of Lonelands, and then we're going to move to the next area, in which I think it's going to be North Downs. I'm thinking. This is a perfect time if you don't happen to have North Downs quest, North Downs pack for the Slayer, so you can do the Slayer deeds and get credit and get your turbine points for them. This is a perfect time. In fact, if you think about it, if you get 50% off, so that means you could technically, I mean, you could basically get two quest packs for the price of one. So you could, like, if you're missing, say, Trollshaws and I don't know, a Vendeme or something like that, you could get both of them for the same, just about the same amount as what it would cost for just getting one of them. So that could be super helpful, to say the least. Did I go? Yeah, here we go. Oh no, still a little bit farther to go, Gussie. The red sky's throwing me off. I'm coming out here because I'm pretty sure if I have these green check marks, doesn't that mean that these quests are done? Yeah, ready to complete. And these are all Lonelands. Oatmeal problems. Oh, that goes to Oak Barton. Okay. Well, we'll go try and turn these in really quick. It's weird I'm not seeing a quest thing at all. I wonder if I just do this. Oh, hang on one second, you guys. My husband's calling. Just one sec, please. So sorry about that, you guys. It's my husband, though. What do you expect? I'm not gonna turn down a phone call from my husband. Oh, gracious, bless his heart. It's just been quite a morning already today. Thanks for that, you guys. Yeah, he just got a he just got in to work that we had a I don't know if anybody saw in the news or not, but we had a tanker truck turn over on I-5 about 5 minutes from where he heads in to work usually, and the whole I-5 was shut down in Fife, and we were all kind of panicking just to make sure that he got into work and everything okay. So turbine used to mess up my sub all the time. How exactly do they mess up your subscription? That doesn't, I mean, I'm kind of curious. I can't imagine how. Because, I mean, our subscriptions are pretty much based on how we set them up. So, was it an issue with, like, payment? Well, that's not really. I really shouldn't ask that kind of stuff. But I hope, that being said, that maybe you'll give it a second look if it's been a while ago. Maybe you'll give it a second look. See, now all the rings are popping up showing me where to turn them in. And maybe give it a second chance. I know they have upgraded and updated a lot of their subscription stuff. It's much easier to set up payments and subscriptions now. There's a lot more options opened up to us this past couple of months. They revamped a lot of the system for that type of thing. So if you had a bad experience in the past and you want to come back and play, I would recommend at least giving it a try. Maybe setting up a 1 month or a 3 month, and just giving it a chance and seeing if you find now that it's much better and much more improved. Just depending on what the situation was, it could have just been something that they fixed, that they've already fixed and don't have any problems with anymore. So I can't, like me personally, I can't, I'm a VIP, so I can't say enough about it because I've changed my cards, at least 5 times. Depending on which one I want to use, or just that type of thing, or if I've never had any problems with anything like not going through anything I've purchased hasn't been a problem. I don't know, it's been really good for me. I don't have anything that I can complain about. Okay, so we're gonna turn this in. Oh, Lotro Tavern, thank you for the host. Aver, how are you doing, dear? Good to see you. You've been popping up a lot lately. It's good to see you. They said your bank blocked it, the bank said they didn't give up, and then. Well, that's interesting, huh? Yeah, it's like, why can't I find all these things? And are just really all I needed to do was just put them on the tracker, I suppose. Well, let's go ahead and get the. What weapon do I have? 25, 20. Okay, let's go ahead and at least just get this bow. Oh no, this is picking up a quest. Okay, I don't want to pick up. Okay, next one to turn in. I'm going to, instead of boring you guys with all this driving here, there, or riding here, there, and everywhere, well, I'll go over here first. It's close by. But when we start heading back the other way, I might just bebop real quick. Because all I'm doing is riding around, and what I really want to do is get out and start trying out some of these talents. Things seem to be nice, kind of. Calm and quiet at the moment, so. As long as things don't get super duper hot. I'll be alright for a little bit. Again, you guys, I am going to do a Turbine Point code giveaway today during the stream. Right here on this channel, the Lotro Stream channel. We have the bot set up now to do the raffles, and you can do them right here. So make sure you are a follower of the Lotro Stream channel. And if you are, type in exclamation point raffle, and you'll be entered into the drawing. It's a 500 turbine point code. You could get a couple quest packs with that. And the only thing I ask is that you are available, that you're here when I call out the winner, so that we can get that to you. Okay, we gotta go up through here, this other quest turn in. The reason I'm doing these, in case you were wondering, is because it is a 25% XP weekend. It has started already. So you guys definitely get on your alts, get on your characters, take advantage. Do I have any perks? Ooh, I do. Let's get these experience used up too. 3, 4, and 5. Make sure and check your perks. That's about like everybody says, that's about the one thing that you would use the perks for is the XP. Use it. This is, let's level up faster. Let's even get more done. Go ahead and make sure you use your perks this weekend. I believe it's 5 every 24 hours. So today's Thursday. Should be able to bump some more up again here. in the next day or so. And use that along with your 25% boost. And if you have, say for instance, you're like me and you've got your Darude Stone, or any of your other XP boosts, don't forget, like, let's see here, where are they? Where are they? Did I use them already? You know, your little XP boosts that you can get from your Hobbit boxes, if you've been saving those. I mean, stack this stuff up, you guys. Grab your boosts, spread them out over the time period this weekend, and take advantage and, make the most out of leveling as much as you can, definitely. Okay, we turn in here. Yeah, I remember this. I remember coming in here. That's right.
Deadwater. Tell me what you need or move along.
Tell me what you need or move on. What I don't need is your attitude, mister. Oh, and she's wearing a dress, so I can't see. Let's see. I guess we'll just use the. Let's just use the shoulders for now. Can't really use any of this, but. Turn. These are available quests. Okay, next one is Oak Barton. And where's the other one at? Down here in Minas Irul. Okay, I'm gonna bebop to Minas Irul and we'll go turn that in really quick. And we'll head to Oak Barton and turn that in real quick. Okay,
What
let's
is this
see.
world coming to?
What is this world coming to? Let me just take that ring for now. See, 864 XP. Whew. All right, head over to Oak Barton and turn this one in. And then we'll go ahead to a vending, you guys. That's why I kind of planned it that way. I figured from Oak Barton, at least I can start heading towards a vending.
Hello.
Hello. Whoa, what's this? This is wondrous. I had hoped that you would come. I had not hoped that you would come, but here you are. There are many folk here who are terrified of the strange things happening, myself included among them. If you would help us, I know that we could find a proper way to thank you. I don't think that was where I was supposed to be. I think I picked up a quest I don't need. Oh, there's Nod. Okay. Sorry about that.
Just a moment.
Let's turn these in.
What
And
do you
oatmeal
need?
problems. Okay. So I got 10 turbines for just turning that in. Okay, guys. We are going to head to a vending, which is up this way. Check and see how everybody in chat's doing. Vault space, right, Aver? I'm telling you, my boxes are so full. Wolfen, that's okay. Just realize that's why I didn't permaban you. I just gave you a timeout. Just realize that this is a family game and it's a family channel, and yeah, keep it clean in here. Has the best moose in the world. Avery, you're so awesome. Thank you for that. Moonrager Gamer, how are you? Good to see you. It's wonderful to have you all here. It's so good to see you guys. Micah CD's here. Good to see you, buddy. Oh my God, Avery, you're preaching to the choir. My hunter's wardrobe and everything is just ridiculous. Ridiculously full. It's insane. It's crazy. Maybe next weekend we'll get some again. Last weekend I think was like, stuff for legendaries and stuff like that. So maybe next weekend it'll rotate back through and maybe we'll get some more space again. Because that would be awesome. Alright, so let's head. I don't think I want to go down there. There we go. By the way, you guys, I was learning this on my stream yesterday. If you're a 30-something and you have not done your Slayer deeds for the Shire, in particular, spider goblins and can't remember what the other one was. Wolves, I believe it was. If you have not done them on your low-level characters, head out here to this area. Especially, like I said, if you're in your 30s, 35s-ish, somewhere around there, you want to pick up quick, let's see, 15, 30, 45 turbine points, plus be able to build up some XP and whatnot. Come out here to this part of the map, Bull Roar's Swar, and the spiders out here, 31s, right? The wolves, 30s, and the goblins, I believe, are also about the same. So instead of not getting any XP or anything, where's the goblins at? I know they're around here. I saw them. Well, they're around here. Instead of trying to do it with like the lobby area and plowing through there and stuff, but not getting XP or anything for them, come out to this side of the Shire and do the slayers, the three slayers out here, because you figure a regular plus an advanced, that's 15. So 15, 30, 45 turbine points just on those three alone. There you go. There's the... Oh, this guy, too. He's another one. I believe that's a Slayer. No, I think it's Goblins. Not sure what this is. Man, I don't think he counts. Anyway, yeah, take advantage instead of plowing through, if you're by, especially if you're like by yourself or with somebody or something, come out on this side of the Shire and knock out those three Slayers instead of going back to the starting areas. Let the low characters use that area. Come out this side, you'll get your XP boosts, your XP bonuses, probably some drops that you could use in terms of you know, maybe gear and stuff like that, and you know, it'll work out a little bit better for you that way. Did Elda send me a message about the maps? I know that she'd posted something. I just haven't had a chance to talk to her. But I'm sure that she can... Sickle flies. There you go. That's another one, too. Yeah. Hey, Noxie. How are you? Oh, my gosh. Good to see you. How did the bog lurkers... We never... None of our Slayer deeds so far in Lone Lands have included the bog lurkers. We just, the group hasn't been able to get enough time to knock out bog lurkers. Some of our groups, we've gotten 7 out of 8 of the Slayers done in Lone Lands in 3 hours. But we always try and go for the trolls first, because the trolls are... elite, or whatever you want to call them. So if you can knock them out as a group together, it's way more advantageous if you're doing Slayer Deed in a group to go knock out the trolls first and then come back and do bog lurkers at your own time or whatever. But yeah, so far we've knocked out 7 out of 8 Slayers, but we haven't been able, I just don't think time-wise that it's possible to get all 8 in under 3 hours. It could be if you were super high level. And the only problem with being super high level in a group is you kill stuff so quickly that the respawns take forever. So it's kind of like a double-edged sword. You really want to get your group together and you really want to knock out as much as possible, but at the same time, if you knock it out too fast, then you're just kind of standing there twiddling your thumbs and going, hurry up and, hurry up and respawn already. Hey, let's do this. What level is this? 33. Let's stop right here and let's give a couple of these a shot. I want to really try this out. Okay, so Heart Seeker. Oh, okay, that's a little powerful. Might have to go a little bit higher. Is that a Slayer? Oh, it's a quest. Find a ranger at the Colossus camp to speak about the wheats that you just found. Okay, well, we're going that way anyway, so. I was thinking 32, I might be able to get a little bit of time in, but I might have to head up just a little bit closer to the camps. Gosh, so good to see all of you coming in here this afternoon. The trolls are fun in a group. Yeah, absolutely. And that's what we've really been trying to do, the trolls, when we're in the groups. The maps, it's about the new. Yeah, there's like Wolf, I remember there's in the coding, there's a section that we take out of the coding, and then it when you take that section of coding out, it makes the map full size again. I was telling Eldolith, I was like, I just can't remember off the top of my head what that section was, or where it is I need to go to do it. So, but yes, thank you. She did message to me that she'd gotten information about it. It was just a matter of she's been super busy, I've been super busy, and we just haven't had a chance to touch base type of thing. Another stable
How
master.
can I be of service?
How can I be of service? Okay, now we're at this point. Do we want to get to ten? Let's go ahead and head to Tinidor
Would you do something for me?
32. Yeah, let's go ahead and move forward and pick up Tinidor, and maybe start questing from right there. Did I have a turn in? Oh, okay. Let's see how much. Two. He does. It definitely does seem like that the DPS is a lot stronger. Something was making him slow down. Oh, here's the guy I need to turn into.
Greetings.
These look like any other river weeds that I have seen a dozen times. You say they soothed your skin upon touching them. Yes, I feel
Might I take
that.
a moment of your time?
All right, we'll come back to this area in a little bit. I want to go ahead and head over to the other area. Okay, head up here. Was it you, Wolf, that was it you that told Eldolith what to do in order to make the maps full size? Or is it that you had the same question as well? I'm kind of confused. Is it that you also want to find out how to fix the maps, or do you know how to fix the map? And you were trying to explain it, or let her know. That statue is amazing. I love this. Look at that. Hello, boys. So cool. That is pretty cool. Let's see, I think I want to go this way, yeah. Okay. Pie eating champion. Where did I get pie eating? I think that was the spring festival. Okay. You have the new skins as well. Okay. Gotcha. Okay, cool. Aren't they amazing? The skins are so awesome. I think that is such a great add-on. I kind of wish they'd come up with some more. I mean, I'm happy with what we have, but it'd kind of be cool if we came up with some more too. Okay. Now that's interesting. How did I already have this stable master, but I didn't have, I must have rode past it or something in the past. Okay. What level quests are you?
Stay
36. Okay, so here we go. This is a little bit more what I'm looking at. Welcome to Tinadir. I can show you secret paths by which you can lead your fellowship here quickly, but you must prove to me that you are worthy to be taught such skills. You must know what to look. I've hidden one of my arrowheads somewhere in a vending. If you can pick up my trail and follow the signs, you'll be able to recover the arrowhead and prove to me that you are ready. If not, well, perhaps another hunter will succeed where you fail. Trash man's here. It's okay. It's all right, baby. Shh. It's okay. It's all right. Hang on, you guys. Indy's getting. It's all right. It's okay. Good girl. Good girl. It's okay. You can lay down. Good girl. I'll tell you this, I crossed the bridge from Tinder to the mainland, so you'll want to begin your search for my trail there. We'll pick that up. Excuse me. And ladies and gentlemen, there is Kalinglad.
How can I be of service?
One of our astute Grey Company men.
Greetings.
As you can see, we are here with intentions to reclaim some of our heritage. Imagine our surprise to find the ruins crawling with minions of the enemy. If it interests you, we could use your aid. That's interesting. Loyalty's
What do you mean?
proof, 35. Okay, so we're gonna have to do quests for all three of these people. We'll pick that up. I'm not gonna read through a lot of
What
these
can I do
today
for you?
because I'm trying to. It's just so hot. I just don't want to wear myself out. Have you been to the encampment of our brothers in the North Downs? Once fair Esteldine still serves us honorably, even now, as a base for our rangers to train and prepare for the forces of Angmar pour down from the northern wastes. Not that we don't need your help here, but maybe you wish to speak with Nethir in Esteldine. I've heard the matters there be. See, this is kind of like going hand in hand with North Downs. I'll go and pick that up too. But we're not going back out to North Downs right now. Okay, now see my boat guy? He's already got his picked up too. So I must have rode
Stay
out
on
here at
this.
one time or another and just don't recall it off the top of my head. You've been sent here by Aragorn. Defeat the bats and defeat the Barsts. Pick that up.
Would you do something for me?
Search the jetsam along the shore. Should be one other quest. Oh, there he is.
Stay a moment.
Search the key. Oh. This is over to Troll Shaw's. Don't want to do that.
Might I take a moment of your time?
Talk to the elves of Rivendell. Don't want to do that yet. The Earthkin. Their camp is north of Esteldine, just beyond the Ram Dunath. Nope, not yet.
Could I speak with you a moment?
The land of the east here is called the Field of Twilight. Within it are the ruins of several ancient estates. That's heading over the other way. The places that were once home to powerful families within the kingdom. They grew grain and raised animals, used to feed the city, and provide work for many of the people. Now they are disgraced by robbers, overtaken by nature, desecrated by goblins, and now even serve as a camp from forces of Angmar. I'm going to pick that up too. Okay. Alrighty. So we got some, is it very humid? My in-laws live in Tennessee, and they're saying it's very, very, very hot already. Hey, Deathlane, how are you doing? Good to see you. Radar Wave, good to see you. And Cream XXL, oh my gosh, good to see you too, buddy. You had more rain than sun this summer in your, oh, really? Oh, wow. That's funny, you guys are, I mean, it's not funny, but you guys are getting the wet season, and I'm here in Washington State, and it's like 90-something degrees, and there's like burn, like the red flag, they call red flag last night, which means you can't burn, and like, if you grill, you can't use charcoal, or if you're like camping and stuff, you can't use charcoal right now. It's kind of just crazy. Everything's kind of crazy right now. Oh, I think I have to go back here, too. Yep, here we go. Yeah, I was going to say, I think I have a couple more people to talk to.
Could I speak with you a moment?
Investigate Till Ruinen. I hope I said that right. Tomb Raider sashes. You want to start collecting those because those are for rep. And you want to collect your rep because you want this horse right here. I know you do. It's an awesome, awesome mount.
Will you lend me your ear?
Find the solution to the riddle. Two roads pass through the green fields. Four kings watch the meeting of the ways. That's where the statue is, where we were, so we'll head back down there too. Okay. Do I have to go inside? Oh, right! The jetsams. Here we go. This is the jetsam quest, and they're all along the shoreline. There's six of them. See, right along this shoreline here. There's one. I'm gonna put my horse there so I don't... See, I always put my mounts on the far right side. It's easy for me to remember to click it. Jetsam. Mounts and cosmetics. Need them all. That's right. Okay, here we go. Excuse me. Heartseeker. Oh, I can't move. That's right. So again, the new thing that I'm doing, let's do new things, as the stream says, Is I am trying a red line hunter instead of my blue line. Oops, I forgot to get that other jet sound because I got interrupted. Oh yeah, not the yawn. Okay. Three. All right, let's try this guy. Oh, my heart seeker's done, but it's so tempting to strife or to move along. I get mad with Callan Glad because he sent you on a wild goose chase. Well, I know, but he is a ranger. Gotta do what they need us to, we need to help them. Whatever they ask us to do. But yes, I mean, for obviously, no, I don't want to spoilers, but definitely, you guys want to do Volume 1. You definitely want to do your Book 1 quests while you're questing these lower areas, because they intertwine so magnificently that the story is so important. It's so integral. And not only that, but if you do all of Volume 1, you get a mount. And mounts are important. Okay, so Heartseeker. Swift bow seems like it's not so swift. Okay. It's just very hard for me to stand still and shoot. Like, it seems like it's... It's like, why am I standing here taking being hit? Can you guys hear the music? Let me turn the music up a little bit. I tend to turn it down a lot because it gets super loud in my headset. But the music out here is so awesome too. I was looking to see if there was any more strays out here. I'm gonna turn this in. Let's see.
What do you need? Would you do something for me?
Sort small relics on the mat, medium relics on the mat, and large relics on the mat. Okay.
How can I be of service?
Oops. Semper Fidelis, Marine.
Greetings.
Thank you for your help. You have a good heart and a helpful spirit. I believe that you are indeed a friend of Aragorn's, and I will tell Callan Glad as much. Thank you again for your efforts. All right, we helped him. That was helpful. Woohoo! So we got one of the three. Let's go ahead. Somebody else I gotta turn in around here. Oh, the little, this little spot outside here. Here we go.
Stay stay a moment.
Defeat Jabe Grimshaw. Calenglad is a wise ranger who's seen many summers, and I trust his judgment as my own. If he's not convinced of your honesty, I will remain unconvinced as well. Okay, in Tirn Fornek, an ancient stone overlook stands watch atop one of the tallest hills. Okay, we're gonna pick up this quest too, because I need to earn his trust. Let's change some of these colors. I don't need the Tomb Raider sash quest up here, because I know we'll just get those while we're doing, and that's reputation. I don't want to waste that on. Evendim. Here we go. Okay, we'll do those for now. Let's change some of these colors so I can at least see the difference. White and yellow. Okay. I get a little disorientated, sorry. Head up this way. We got that puzzle. Okay, here's some subtle tracks right here. Remember he was saying that he wants us to follow the tracks? These marks in the dirt leave no question. The trail here leads southeast. Okay, so southeast. Southeast. I'm kind of glad I'm doing this at nighttime, because I seem to have an easier time seeing shinies. Oh, that Heartseeker does do some damage, doesn't it? Jeez whiz. I just wish it was a faster definitely the DPS is definitely stronger, that's for sure. The Shire horse is not. Yes, it is. That's a very nice one, too. Hey, Tally. How are you doing, hun? Hey, stream. Hi, Lodge. You guys, don't forget we are. Let's see. Trailheads. Trail here leads southeast. Don't forget, you guys, if you're just joining here on the channel, we will be doing a turbine. What just happened? Tansy, thank you. Oh, you're so awesome. Thank you so much for that. Thank you. You're awesome. Wait a minute. I'm going to put that on my bar. Dum, 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 dum. That wants some mates. Thank you for that. Appreciate that. You're awesome. Thank you for that. Oh, new deed. Ruins of Evendim. Hey, Gussie, why don't you get on your mount? Yeah, I know it needs to be used as a first shot, but when it's in the middle of, what's the word I want to use? Like, you have to wait for it to come back up to use it again. I'm sorry, you guys. Excuse me for yawning. Anyway, as I was saying, 500 turbine point code giveaway tonight, or today, during the stream. So just make sure you're a follower of the LOTRO stream page, and then go ahead and type in exclamation point raffle, all one word, and you will be entered into the drawing. The marker bears an inscription all but worn away with the passing of time. To settle disputes, men fight in the ring of stone. Outside the wall, my marker lies hidden. That's going to go up this way. Wasn't there something I had to do down here too? Seems like there was something I was supposed to do at the statue, isn't there? Just going to check really quick, but I could have swore it said something about. Oh no, that's where I was. Duh, Gussie, you were just there. Okay. North. We want to go north now. Okay. I'll blame it on the heat. So good to have you all here with me today. Looking forward to seeing everybody next week on my Gussie Moose One page. We'll be back streaming Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday over there as well. And then Thursday, next Thursday, we'll be right back here again. Don't forget, tomorrow I will post the remaining two servers. I believe it's Crick Hollow and Laurelin are the two remaining servers. To vote for next Tuesday's Slayer Deed, Slayer Deed Tuesday. It will be Lone Lands Slayer Deeds, and it will either be Crick Hollow or Laurelin. I'll make a post on my Twitter tomorrow, and you guys will have all weekend to vote your server. So make sure and let everybody know. Spread the word, and I will announce the winner on Monday. And that way, it'll give you a day and a half or whatever to prepare yourselves. But I'll be honest with you, with XP weekend and stuff being up this week, I would, if you have two low-level characters or medium-level characters over there, Laurelin and Crick Hollow, prepare for it. If you want to come and join me in the gang Tuesday for Slayer Deeds, take this weekend to get a character to like level 19, 20. And get them out there to the Forsaken Inn in the Lone Lands and get yourself some Slayer Deed books. And get yourself ready on both servers, and then that way, whichever one wins, you can come and join myself, Saint Joan, you know, whoever wants to come with me next Tuesday, and we'll get that taken care of. Yep, there it is. It's down there. That's right. Oof. Okay. The marker bears an inscription. From this beach, you can see Rantost, a short swim across the river. This new riddle may reveal the true location of the treasure. That's. Where's loyalty's proof? That's up there too. Okay. Why does this keep coming back up? I don't want that. The Burning Island. There we go. Okay, that's out that way. Okay, so we'll go. We're gonna head west and north for these two quests, Loyalty Proof and the Spy from the Heights. Oof. Isn't there a way? Thought there was a back way. Unfriendly man. If you know what's good for you, you'll get out of my sight. Well, you're just a walk in the park, aren't you, Betty? Oh,
hello,
there's
there.
Par.
Can't I speak with you a moment?
Spend time looking for boars in a vending. Well, I've decided I've never had an avending boar before, so I thought I might as well try some while I'm here. Should have been a simple matter of finding a nice, healthy boar. But you know what? I haven't seen a single boar since I've come here. Oh, gosh. I'm going to pick that up for shits and giggles, but we all know how difficult that one is to find, don't we? See if I go red. See, it doesn't help. That's funny. I guess I do have to just go down and around, don't I? Okay. Yeah, I'll do the Hobbit presents. I'm hoping I can get to 38, and then as soon as I get to 38, I'll go ahead and open them up. I just thought I'd try and move it to the next level real quick. Hold on one second, you guys. I apologize. Sorry about that, you all. I don't want to get too much into it, but me and my husband got really lucky, and we were able to refi our house this past couple weeks. We've been working on it, and actually dropped it from a 4.5 to a 3.5. So that was the notary. They're going to be coming out next week. We're going to be doing some paperwork and signings and stuff like that. So I apologize for the couple of phone call interruptions, but basically, in a nutshell, that's what it was. We got really lucky, and we were able to knock down our interest on our house. So, very, very happy about that. We worked hard to do that. So, and no more interruptions on the phone, I promise. We're all good. There's boars down the hill. Yeah, I was chit-chatting. I wasn't paying attention to where I was steering. I'll probably come back and look for those. What I need to do is get up the hill here. There we go. Oh, hello, Mr. Bear. Dun-dun-dun, dun-dun-dun. Wow, it's really tricky to get up and around, isn't it? What we're doing is, basically what we're doing is what we've planned to do is take the savings from the refinance of our house, and we're taking that and we're just putting it into savings, so we just have a little extra cushion for retirement. So the budget stays the same, but we're moving the money to retirement. I don't understand what the heck is going on here. I need to get on the other side. I need to get over here. And I have mountains blocking my way. I'm not really quite sure how I'm supposed to get over there. Do I have to go completely down the entire road and start over? That can't be, right? This is what happens when you don't quest out in an area for a long time. You forget what you're supposed to do. I feel like everything is blocking me from getting over that way. Beebs, it is. We're using our VA. That's correct. Let's try this way. Okay. I think I might have this. It's like, I know there's got to be a way to get up over on that other side. Here we go. So yeah, we're just, you know, we're trying to just kind of start thinking about getting our ducks in a row and stuff for our future and what we want to do, you know, when he's gotten to the point where he's had enough of being a policeman. And so what we've kind of been thinking about doing is cutting back on, like, maybe cutting the cable on the Comcast. I mean, obviously keeping internet, because unfortunately they do have the best internet in our area. But cutting back on the house phone and the all the extra stupid TV channels that we don't even use. I use like maybe 10 channels. Here's the thing. What I really wish the cable companies would do is let us pick the channels that we want and pay for the channels that we want to use. I know that will never happen, because if that happens, then they're going to lose a shit ton of money. I know. I understand that. But I have like five. I mean, I know not all of them are consistent, one through such and such. There's a lot of skips in the numbers, but literally I have from channels one through HBO 500 and something. I have all these sports channels that I don't watch. I have all these like foreign channels that I don't watch. I have HD channels that, let's be honest, unless I have like a super awesome TV, I really don't need channel 8 regular and channel 8 HD. Well, you are just the man I'm looking for. See, I'm not liking this standing here thing. I'm not liking this. I get it, but I don't like it. I mean, that's a prime example right there of not, you know, I have to stand there and take it. I don't like that. And it's a personal preference. I'm not dissing on anybody that's doing it or anything like that. But I just don't like standing here and doing nothing. Get Kodi for your PC and stream TV to your house. Oh. Well, I do have Netflix, I do have Hulu, and I do have Chromecast. So, I mean, that helps a lot. The problem I have is there's about probably a total of 10 shows that we do like. We love Walking Dead. We love Game of Thrones. We love, was it A&C, A&E? They do a lot of, like, you know, the Alaskan family, the crabbing one, ID channel, FYI, we like the tiny house shows, flip the house shows, all those kinds of things. Like, we love those kinds of shows. And unfortunately, in order to watch about 2/3 of them, you gotta have this huge package of channels that you don't watch. It's a little frustrating. I mean, they're not stupid. They have us hook, line, and sinker. You know, Walking Dead's going to be coming back in October. We've got Halt and Catch Fire comes back on next week. So you got all these shows, like, it's like, oh, I really want to disconnect, but I'm afraid I'm not going to be able to see these shows. There's a couple of, like, police shows that Bill likes to watch, and I can't find one solution that's still going to allow me to watch the stuff that we want to watch. And it's almost like I just feel like they just have us, you know, like, hey, if you really like these shows enough, you're just going to have to suck it up, Buttercup, and you're just going to have to pay for it, whether you like it or not. That's just the way it's going to be. And, you know, I don't want to wait 2 years to watch something that's coming out next week. You know, I've thought about going to satellite instead of Comcast. But then you get you kind of get put into the same situation. Cody lets you see them all. You pick the channels. What is this thing called? Right. They're on Netflix and stuff, but the only problem is the current ones won't be. And that's the thing. It's like, oh, do I want to wait until next year to watch these, or I want to watch them currently? I mean, that's half the fun, is watching them, you know, when they come up. So, I don't know. It's a tricky catch-22, because it is something that Bill and I love to do, is, you know, have our... He comes home from work. I usually make him, like, a Shakeology shake or something like that. You know, we sit down with the dogs for a few minutes, let him kind of unwind and relax and stuff, and then we watch some TV. I'll record stuff during the evening, and then he can watch it when he comes home, type of thing. So, you know, I really think that the companies, they know this, you know? I mean, obviously, they know this. See, I love that Heartseeker knocks off so much right off the bat, but what I don't like is that it takes 90 seconds for it to come back up again. First rank unlocks the skill. Second rank causes Heartseeker to deal additional damage to crowd-controlled targets. I don't really need that at the moment. So, see, and then it's just like, okay, now I have to wait for Heartseeker, so all I can do right now is just use my other casts, which is fine in a situation like this guy where he doesn't move. But what about the new deed, invaders from Angmar? But what about the characters, that do move or that come at me? It's true, I could use my pinning shot and whatnot, but I still have to situate myself. Angmarim Expeditionary. Okay, that's deeds. Yeah, these are deeds. Okay. Look into Sling TV. It's mostly basic cable channels, but for game H by the HBO Now monthly sub. Oh yeah, bills come first. I mean, for sure. And that's not the issue. I mean, it's not like I have to give it up. It's just a matter of, what is this that dropped? It's just a matter of, why am I paying for shit that I don't need, you know? Okay, Lupus, I will. Here, hang on, I'll Twitch message you right now. Right, hon, I am sending you a message. Okay. That might have been sent from Lotro, not me, so just keep your eyes open. Yeah, and that's the thing, Wolf, you're right. Like, I've been a Comcast Xfinity One, whatever you call it. Like, I've had it for like, let's see, Bill will be a cop here 10 years in November, so 10 years we've been a triple play. Not once have they ever, hey, thanks for being so loyal for all these years. I would like to offer you the same discount that we give to new subscribers. That really pisses me off. I get that you don't want everybody having the same price as a new subscriber, but my God. It's getting out of control. I mean, I know lots of people do it. I don't need to have cable. It's just one of those things that we enjoy having, at our fingers if we want to watch a TV show or something. Oh, hun, my Comcast is $265 a month. Yeah. Now, I will say this, I do have not the top internet tier, but the one right under it. Which I'm fine with. I mean, it's like me and Bill were saying, like, I'd rather pay for speed. Oh my God, it's already 87 degrees here. Jesus. Tomorrow's supposed to be 97. Saturday's supposed to be 95. Holy cow. We might be sleeping downstairs tonight with the air conditioner. Let's see here. What am I looking for? Isn't there like a thing on Comcast that like tells you what your speed is? Speed test, I think it is. Xfinity speed test, here we go. Seattle. This will give you guys an idea. And like I said, I make no bones about it. I pay for it, but I'm fine with paying for. My download is 83. It peaks at 85. I'm at 83 right now. My upload is 11, peaks at 12. And that's the one below the top tier, I think. I talked to Comcast once before. I was like, okay, so if I cut off my house phone and cut off the cable TV and, bump up to the top tier, I think it would go up to like $90 a month or something like that, which I'm fine with. It's just a matter of do I want to give up all those channels that we do like to watch, you know? Excuse me, you guys. Don't know what to do for dinner tonight. I don't want to cook anything, it's too hot. Okay, try a barbed arrow. That. And that. Okay. All right. I'm just going to take this time to practice this skill. So we got quick shot, swift bow, barbed arrow, and then into penetrating shot. See, if I'm in a controlled situation like this, I'm fine. Barbed arrow. It just seems like though if I'm not in a controlled, environment, like, if some of them are sneaky or whatever, that I feel like, oh my God, you're right up in my face, get away from me. I want to move away to avoid being hit. Barbed. A melting gussy. And that is true, Wolf. I have not played that card yet. That is a good idea. Yeah, Comcast does TV, internet, and phone. You can get their bundle them, and you get it's called Xfinity or Xfinity Plus or whatever or the heck it is. Order pizza? That sounds really good. Wolf, I had tuna melts the other night. What was it, Monday, you guys? I did tuna. When you're stronger, it should take more than a few shots to kill him, plus you get your triple shot. Oh, that's a good point. I'm gonna keep working with her on Redline because I'm not the kind of person who's gonna be like, oh, I don't like this, forget it. I wanna give it a good, fair shot at work at trying it out. But I just, it feels really weird, you know? After being blue line for so long, it just feels really weird. Oops, I forgot to heart seeker first. Well, I got my sashes. I'm probably gonna stream for maybe about 15, 20 more minutes. It's really starting to get hot up here. What I would like for you guys to do is, if you haven't done so already, please go tell your friends, family, you know, anybody you can think of, your kin mates. Let everybody know that, oh, I remember this place. I think these guys give deeds too. We'll try one. Let everybody know we're getting ready to do a turbine point code giveaway in the next in up here pretty soon, in the next few minutes here. Yep, that's a deed also. Okay. Well, that's okay. I can kill a few more. It won't kill me. I've gotten my thought process so much into like, oh, I don't want to finish a do a deed because I want to save the character for Slayer Deeds Tuesdays. But I need to realize it's okay. It's okay to kill things. Anyway, pass the word out. If you guys have a few minutes, you know, maybe let your world chats know, your kin mates know, whoever. If you have a friend who's AFK or anything, let them know that we're gonna get ready to do the turbine point code giveaway shortly here. And I want to thank Cordovan and Quartermaster Yu for hooking up the community with some special goodies. Hooking me up with the you know, the chance or the availability to offer a code, you know, when I stream to the community. There we go. Here's another Tomb Raider. So we'll probably do that here shortly, and then looks like I do have a couple of these quests I can go turn in real quick. Let's do that. Let's head down the hill. We'll go turn in what we've got. So yeah, I'm definitely gonna keep working on this. I am gonna keep her red line. Nimwin is blue line. I'm gonna keep her in red line. I'm gonna really give it a good shot and really try it. I'll just see how it goes, you know. Again, I'll be off this weekend, but I will be visiting other streamers and their channels. Hopefully, I believe tomorrow. I know Professor Tolkien has been traveling a lot, but hopefully, I believe he's going to try and stream tomorrow here on this channel, tomorrow morning at his usual time. And I love his streams. I learned so much from his streams. Definitely, please give him a shot. Give him a look-see tomorrow. Come back and check his streams out. The shinies have been told about the rat. Oh, thank you, Aver. I appreciate that. Oh, I need to get a hold of Stina too because I got on my Sims character last night and. For whatever reason, it's saying that her and my house that I started are in the gallery. The only thing that I'm not sure is, did I put her in the wrong. Oh, the tracks. We forgot to do this, you guys. My bad. Let's do this real quick. Did I put her in the wrong gallery, or am I just not doing something right? But if anybody's interested in playing Sims 4, I made a Gussie Moose character. She looks kind of like me, sort of. Kinda. She's got short gray hair, glasses, and is wearing a t-shirt and a pair of shorts. And she loves cooking and that type of thing. And the character is Gussie Moose, all one word, Gussie Moose. So I put that in in gallery, and I put my house in the gallery. Like I said, I'm not sure if I did it right or not, though. That's the only thing. I'm trying to do it so that other friends can put me into their little family unit or whatever if they want to. Did I miss that? Excuse me. Stop popping up there. Okay, I'm gonna go back down and turn these in. Oh, Steen, hi! I didn't see you in here. Hi, sweetie. Find scratched arrowhead. And yeah, and that's like I said. Hey, hola! How are you, sir? You found me. Okay, so I did it. Okay. Isn't it funny, Stina? She kind of looks like me a little. You gotta put me in your kitchen because she loves cooking. My little house is in there too in the gallery. It's not too spectacular, but all right, let's see what this thing says. The marks in the dirt leave no question the trailhead here. Okay, southeast still. Okay. So I gotta go up this way a little bit. So we're gonna finish this trail, you guys, and then when I go turn these quests in, we'll get ready to go do our turbine point code giveaway. And then Gussie's going to get ready to call it shortly thereafter because it's really getting hot in here right now. My weather thing said, oh, here we go, subtle tracks. My weather thing said 87 degrees right now, and it's not 4 o'clock yet, and 4 o'clock is the hottest part of the day here. It is not likely that Horace came this way. Well, which way did he come then? Southeast. You look smashing, Stina. She's wearing a t-shirt and a pair of shorts. I will, oh, here's subtle tracks. I will try and find out what I can this weekend about getting that map thing to where it goes to full size. There's a little question, your keen eye, that Horace's trail here bends southwest. Southwest. Oh dear. He goes down. He goes down by the water, doesn't he? If I remember correctly. Oh, that's gonna hurt. Guess you should get a moose pet in The Sims. I hope they put pets in eventually. I don't think they have any pets at the moment. But I would love that very much. I would love to like be able to have like a cat and a dog pet for Sims. I think that would be kind of cool. I might work on my character later on when it cools off a little bit, but it's like after I get done with the stream, I'm just gonna shut down for a little bit because this room is super hot right now. Southwest. Should be some tracks. I don't want to look for like an hour. Oh, southwest. I swear I want to say the tracks were around here somewhere. Oh no! Oh, Gussie, you derp. Gussie fell. At least she fell into the water. How pretty is this, you guys? Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? I might not get this quest finished. I might just go ahead and bebop and finish it on the next stream. Because I don't think I can get back up there very easily. In fact, let's go ahead and do that. Let's go bebop and turn these in. Turn these in and then we'll open up our Hobbit gifts and we're going to do the raffle. Do I feel cooler now? Big Tuna, I see you in here. Okay, you guys, again, last call. You guys go ahead and come on, change the screen over. Guys, go ahead and prepare. I'm going to turn these in real quick and then we'll get ready to do the raffle. Oh, Stina, by the way, honey, you can do it on the Lotro page. We don't have to go to my page anymore. Eldolith has set up Moobot to where we can do the raffles on the Lotro's page. So, if some of you out of habit are, if you're used to going back over to Gussie Moose 1 to do it, you don't have to do that anymore. You can, but you do need to be a follower of the Lotro page in order to have the bot recognize your command. Okay, we'll turn that in.
Speak with you a moment.
We'll accept this for now. We'll probably come back and stream this one some more on Monday. Where else can we turn in? Wasn't there one more turn in up here? Oh, it's up that ways. Okay. Well, we'll just park her here for right now. Oh my god, it's so hot, you guys. Jeez. Okay. You have been a great help to me, Callie. That's so cool. I am satisfied that you are a friend of Aragorn. Well, thank you, sir. I appreciate that. All right. Elda does fix everything. Okay, you guys, last call. Exclamation point. Oh, let me pull the codes up here real quick. Notepad. Turbine points. Hold that thought for a second. Oh, that's right. He sent them to me on the message. That's right. I was like, I know Cordova sent them to me. Let's see. Direct message. No, that's not what I want. How do I do this thing? One sec, you guys. Hang in there. Just one second. have to find where he sent me the message. I know it was on Slack. There we go. Okay. All right, you guys, I have them. Okay. Exclamation point raffle. You guys get your exclamation point raffles all up in there. Is there anybody streaming? I don't see anybody streaming right now. Is there anybody that's on any of our LOTRO streamers that are going to be streaming shortly? Or that want to pop on shortly on their channel. If you're feeling like you want to go streaming in the next 5-10 minutes, let me know down here and we'll make sure and send everybody over to your page. But we're going to do this raffle and then I'm going to wrap it up because I just can't take any more of this heat right now. Coldspell, how are you doing? Good to see you. Beeps, we do have a portable one, and we also have one that's in the window of our kitchen. The problem we have with the portable is, I know you can't see my window behind, all of the windows in our houses out here open like this, and they're big windows, as you can see from behind me. I don't know if you can see from behind me, but it's a big window. And the portable air conditioners are usually the faceplate, the back that you hook into a window, is about that big and wants a window that goes up and down so you can shut it on it. So the portable air conditioners are super awesome, but I can't put them into any of my windows except the kitchen. Now I put a box one in the kitchen. The whole, now downstairs is cool as a cucumber. Downstairs is fantastic. It feels great. Bill and I will probably just air up the air mattresses and sleep downstairs with the dogs all weekend. Yeah, this one's on wheels too. Like I said, the only problem is it's one of those tall ones and it's kind of like shaped like this. The only problem is, like I said, is you have, even though it's a portable air conditioner, you have to hook them up into a wall or into a window. And our windows in this whole neighborhood, DR Horton home building thing, are all windows that are like 5 feet tall and they're like this. So we can't, we're not allowed to put, my HOA won't let us put anything up in the windows that makes it look blocked, for lack of a better word. I don't know how else to explain it. It's kind of anal, to be honest with you. A ceiling portable. Yeah, what I'd really like to have is one of those Mitsubishi ones that you can like put up on your wall, but those things are so expensive. Yeah, like I said, I've got one and it's on wheels and stuff, but the only thing is even though they're portable, you still have to put your drain thing, or you know, the out vent, you still have to hook it up to a window. It's portable in the sense you could take it and put it in any room you want to, but you still have to have it hooked up to a window somewhere. And then plus you've got to have something to allow the water to drain, you know, to catch, like a bucket or something of that nature too. So anyway, we'll just camp out in the living room all weekend if we have to. okay, you guys, yeah, if there's anybody who's going to be popping on streaming in the next few minutes or wants to stream on their page or anything, do me a favor, post in the chat really quick. Let us know that you're going to be on so that we can Get situated and head over there. Yes, that's it, Wolf. Thank you. Has to be facing outside. Exactly. Okay. Last call. Exclamation point raffle. Pull up my page. Oops. Okay. Don't need this. Cordovan. I got my codes right here. Okay. Awesome sauce. Again, you guys, just want to give you one more quick heads up. The new sales for the Lotro store are up. The freebie of the week is a sturdy steel key. Expansions and your expansion quest packs are all 50% off. Skirmishes, enhanced XP supplies, Hornburg token, and mark acquisition books are all 30% off. This is a good time to hang out this weekend and get some leveling done for sure. Oh, Mort. Hey, buddy, how are you? It's hot, Mort. It's like 92 degrees in my room right now. I'm gonna shut. Yes, Aver 50 quest packs and the expansions are 50% off. All right, you guys, last call. Let's see. Again, just make sure you announce yourself in the chat if you are the winner, and I will Twitch message you from this page, and I will send you your turbine point code, and you'll be ready to go for the weekend. Okay? Okay, guys, get ready! Exclamation point raffle, last call. All right. Ready, guys? Good luck to everybody. And here we go. 10, 9, 8, cold spell, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Retarius 1. Retarius, are you in the chat? Just say something in the chat so that I know you are here. Retarius 1. You are. There you are. Really? Yes, you are the winner. Congratulations to you. That's awesome. Okay, hang on one second. I'm going to copy and paste this code. Now remember, you can use these codes right on the Turbine Shop in game now. Just simply go to the top where it says redeem code and copy and paste that to there. And this is for 500 turbine points. So thank you very much, Cordovan, again. You and Quartermaster, you both, for the hookup. Appreciate that. Let's see here. Where is my message? There we go. TP code. Congrats to you. It looks like. Paste. Okay. Sending to you right now. And it's on its way. Just do me a favor. Let me know, even if you just send it back in Twitch message, just let me know that you've used your code and that it went through. And that way I can check it off the list and prepare for next week as well. Oh, thank you, Seven Hero, for that. Appreciate that. All right, you guys. Is okay, last call, you guys, streamers in the chat, in the channel. Is there anybody that's getting ready to pop on? Anybody that's going to be streaming on their channel? Shout out really quick and we'll go head over your way. Because I just can't take this heat anymore. I'm going to have to go downstairs and cool off. I do want to take a moment, you guys. While you're here, it's been a really great week to come back. I missed you guys the last couple of weeks. It's really nice to be back. More Umbra is going to be on in 45 minutes. Okay, boss. So you guys make sure follow Mort Umbra and head over to his channel in about 45 minutes. And go and hang out with him. I'll probably do like Lupus suggested and order myself a pizza for dinner because I am not turning on the kitchen for anything. Wolf, and everybody that's in the chat, as far as the UI goes, I will try really hard this weekend, by this weekend or whatever, to find out what that is that we have to do to fix our maps so that they go full screen like this. I know we have to get into the UI file, and I know there's a chunk of text that we simply highlight and delete and then save. I just don't know what it is. I don't remember what it is. So hopefully by this weekend, we can get an answer up and get that situated so all of our community will know what to do and everybody will be able to enjoy the UIs a lot more. Again, you guys, thank you very much for coming and hanging out today. Thanks for joining me on my channel this week. I will be back on Monday, 4 o'clock p.m. Eastern on the Gussie Moose 1 channel, and we will continue questing and lollygagging around in Middle Earth. I love you guys. Have a good weekend. Don't forget Mort Umbra in about 40 minutes on his channel. You guys know the drill, right? Let's put this up here. There you go. There we go. You all know the drill. Oh, I really need to cut my hair this weekend. You guys take care of yourselves and take care of each other. And I will see you all back bright and early in Middle Earth. I'll catch you in some of the chats this weekend for sure. I'll be in other streamers' chats. I love you guys. Have a good afternoon or good evening. Stay cool. Stay dry, whatever it is you're going through, just try and stay comfortable. And I will see you guys. I'll remember, follow my Twitter tomorrow. I will post up Crick Hollow or Laurelin. Those are the two remaining servers left for the Lone Lands Slayer Deeds next Tuesday. So two more weeks, and then we're gonna go into the next area. So all right. You guys have a good night. I love you. You guys take care of yourselves. I'll see you around Middle Earth. Take care.